The infamous meteorite that struck Earth millions of years ago, causing the extinction of dinosaurs, is regarded as the most well-known of all meteorites and extinctions. Although it resulted in the demise of approximately 75% of all species on Earth at the time, it wasn't the most catastrophic event in Earth's history. This extinction event was just one of five major ones, with one nearly eradicating all life. This significant event is referred to by scientists as the Great Dying. Hello everyone, I'm Ahmed Mahmoud. But before we start, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell so you can get our videos as soon as they're released. The Permian-Triassic extinction event, also known as the Great Dying, was an unprecedented catastrophic period in Earth's history. During this time, life in all its forms became extremely rare, with between 90% and 97% of species becoming extinct. Life on Earth was scarce, terrifying, and surrounded by disasters from all sides. There was no period in Earth's history, before or after, that was as dangerous. What's worse is that this period was not short but lasted for tens of thousands of years. Even insects, which usually survive disasters, were on the verge of extinction. After this critical period ended, it took millions of years for the terrestrial and marine ecosystems to recover. Scientists estimate this period to be about 10 million full years, where death was more prevalent than life on Earth. When geologists began documenting life on Earth, they segmented history into four distinct eras, each subdivided into various periods. The initial era is the era of primitive life, followed by the era of old life, then the era of middle life, and finally, the era of modern life. Our focus is on the Permian-Triassic period, named after the Perm region in Russia, where the remains of creatures from this period were discovered. The Permian period marks the end of the old life era and is directly succeeded by the Triassic period, both terms having identical meanings in English and Latin. Interestingly, our catastrophic extinction event spanned a considerable duration, impacting both the conclusion of the Permian and the commencement of the Triassic period. However, the pivotal question is what factors contributed to the severity of this extinction, making it more potent than other extinctions and resulting in such a high fatality rate. As stated at the outset of the episode, there have been five major extinction events throughout Earth's history. The most renowned is the fifth extinction, triggered by the meteorite that eradicated the dinosaurs. It's crucial to note that the meteorite isn't the sole hypothesis for this extinction, but it is the most popular. Similarly, the remaining extinctions have causes akin to the meteorite. For instance, the primary suspect in the first extinction is the leakage of gamma rays to Earth. Each of the other extinctions also has a specific suspect under scrutiny, except for the Great Extinction, the third extinction. Researchers propose that there wasn't a single culprit behind it. During the Great Extinction, Earth endured disasters for thousands of years. Interestingly, the event that precipitated this horrifying extinction wasn't extraordinarily powerful. It wasn't a colossal meteorite, nor cosmic rays leaking to Earth. It was a period of Earth's instability, a collection of earthquakes, volcanoes, hurricanes, and all known disasters. They weren't necessarily destructive to Earth individually, but they were potent enough to persist and prevent anything from recovering. Scientists infer periods of Earth's instability using various techniques such as analyzing fossils, the Earth's crust, ocean floor sediments, mineral deposits, sedimentary layers, and many other techniques. Ultimately, the numbers are large lie estimated and approximated. But the key point is that the continuous disaster hypothesis is almost confirmed among researchers. The current debate is about what sparked these continuous disasters and what made them start. The primary hypothesis explaining the occurrence is that it was an unstable period in Earth's history and there was no specific cause. It was a natural phase in Earth's lifespan. The second hypothesis, which isn't as widely accepted as the first one concerning the fifth extinction that wiped out the dinosaurs, implicates the Chicxulub meteorite. However, when we delve into the Great Extinction, the scenario becomes more intricate. If a meteorite was indeed the catalyst for the Great Extinction, we're referring to a meteorite that triggered a nuclear winter lasting a minimum of 200,000 years. For a meteorite to create such an enormous impact, it would need to be a minimum of 5 or 6 times larger than the Chicxulub meteorite. This theory gained momentum after a scientific discovery made in 2006. In that year, scientists unearthed evidence of a colossal impact in a region known as Wilkes Land in Antarctica. This region houses a crater measuring 500 kilometers in diameter, situated 1,600 meters beneath the ice. If we hypothesize that this crater was formed by a giant meteorite, then the diameter of this meteorite would not be less than 50 kilometers. If this theory holds true, it's logical that a meteorite of this magnitude would be the initial spark that set off a series of subsequent events, comprising a multitude of disasters. The third proposition put forward by scientists is the Siberian Traps theory. This theory is predicated on the fact that present-day Siberia is abundant in volcanic rocks from the Permian period, and that the colossal Siberian volcano was also the initial trigger for the sequence of events leading to the planet being inundated with lethal acid rain. According to this theory, scientists posit that the volcano spewed out enormous quantities of lava and gases, plunging Earth into an extended nuclear winter and wiping out the majority of life forms. However, this theory encounters a substantial hurdle. The massive volume of lava and gases that the volcano would need to emit to cause such an impact necessitates an extraordinarily formidable volcano. For instance, the Toba volcano, deemed the largest in recorded history, discharged 2,800 cubic kilometers of lava and gases. This volcano, which erupted 74,000 years ago, resulted in the extinction of a multitude of species. However, if the Great Extinction was indeed triggered by the Siberian volcano, then this volcano would need to emit 150,000 cubic kilometers of lava, ash, and gases. This implies that it would need to possess 43 times the strength of the Toba volcano. The fourth theory proposed by scientists is grounded on the analysis of a vast number of fossils. Scientists noticed the abrupt emergence of a type of bacteria known as Methanosarcina before the Great Extinction. This bacteria possesses the capability to generate methane. The crux of this theory is that a substantial increase in methane gas on Earth's surface ultimately led to the eradication of a majority of life forms. This is attributed to methane being one of the most detrimental greenhouse gases contributing to global warming. A significant surge in methane could lead to oxygen depletion in the atmosphere, resulting in the suffocation of all living organisms. According to this theory, these bacteria proliferated, and with their growth, the rate of air pollution persisted over the years. Gradually, oxygen levels in the atmosphere began to diminish, and over a span of 200,000 years, organisms continued to go extinct. The theory further postulates that the rate of oxygen reduction could have hit zero, annihilating all life on Earth, if not for the exhaustion of elements essential for the survival of these bacteria, primarily nickel. In other words, when the nickel was depleted and the bacteria themselves began to perish, life on Earth was salvaged. The theory suggests that during this period, 97% of life vanished from the face of the Earth. The final fifth hypothesis also relates to methane, but this time the suspect is the temperatures on Earth itself. Methane hydrates, or methane clathrates, are found in vast quantities on the ocean floors and are considered a newly discovered source of clean energy. However, the problem is that when temperatures rise significantly, these hydrates melt just like ice and release methane gas into the atmosphere. This could lead to a series of events that eventually extinguish all life forms. In other words, according to this hypothesis, the excess methane didn't come from bacteria, but was released from the ocean floors due to rising temperatures. Despite the diversity of these theories, they all ultimately revolve around one central theme. During the Permian-Triassic period, Earth experienced a series of successive disasters. Regardless of the original cause or initial spark, whether it was instability on Earth, a meteorite, or a disruption in oxygen levels, it was an unparalleled period in Earth's history that nearly ended all life. That's it for now. If you've made it this far, you're awesome. Don't forget to give us a like before you leave so we can see how many made it to the end. And remember, If you have any suggestions for future episodes, leave them in the comments. Most of the episodes we're making now are based on your comments. See you. Have a good night. Bye.